I recently bought an electric bicycle. And it's the Electra Cruiser Go. I love that thing. It's a budget electric bicycle, which they can get very, very pricey. The bicycle itself is fantastic. So I've been riding this bicycle for about 3 months now. Honestly, it's been fantastic, and it reduced how much I relied on things like the car, the family car. I personally don't have a car. My girlfriend has a car. We live together, so I end up driving it all the time. But not as much anymore because this bicycle. Now, outside of going to work, the average person drives less than 3 miles a day. You factor in the commute to work and stuff, yeah, that goes up a lot. But my girlfriend and I actually work from home, both of us. We have for quite a while. So having one car, it makes sense. We don't need it every day. Every errand that I run by myself that's within the area, going to the doctor's, going to the post office, going to the gym, going to the grocery store for picking up small things, most of those are done on the bicycle now. My girlfriend and I often talk about things like upgrading the old Nissan for maybe an electric vehicle, and I've decided that I don't think they are worth upgrading to, and I'll tell you why. The electric bicycle, though smaller and cheaper per kilowatt mile per hour, is far more efficient than a Tesla or any other electric vehicle for that matter. Model 3s, and I'm looking at some of these kilowatt batteries here. Battery capacity 54, 54, 57, 62. Some of them go up to 82. But here's the thing about that. The range is not great. Don't get me wrong, compared to like a traditional gas engine, these ranges are excellent. They still are inferior compared to my budget electric bicycle. Now, granted, my bicycle only has a 250 watt in battery. Here's the thing. That bicycle can get me 15 miles per charge. At being 250 kilowatts, it takes four full charges to hit 1 kilowatt, which means I can't just go 15 miles per charge, but I can also go 60 miles per kilowatt hour. Now, if you look at something like in the 50, 60s, and 70 kilowatt hours, these things are getting around 280 miles for like 71 kilowatts, which really, if you break it down at that point, per mile, they're paying more. So if a Tesla can go 300 miles, like say 75 kilowatt hour battery, that basically means it's 4 miles to kilowatt hour, as opposed to the electric bicycle, as we already discussed, gets 60 miles per kilowatt hour, 4 versus 60. This is not a surprising thing when you really think about it, because when I ride the bicycle, it's got to carry me, my human flesh ball. It has to carry that plus the weight of the bicycle, and the bicycle's like 40 pounds. Here we are on the Tesla website, 4,048 pounds. So not only does it have to carry the passengers, it also has to push an extra 4,000 pounds. So of course it's not going to be as efficient as electric bike, even though it's like aerodynamic. Also, let's be real, it can go at much higher speeds than the electric bike and also doesn't have to stop to charge every 15 miles. But we are still looking at a situation where there is room for drastic improvement. What do we do? How do we fill that gap? Well, realistically, a good portion of it comes down to we kind of got to get the battery out of the car. That's where most of the weight comes from, is the battery. That may seem like a bizarre idea, like how do you take the battery out of a car? But we've been doing it for years with light rail. Light rail that connects the mains, that pulls the car along the way, and comparative to a Tesla, they're very efficient, especially when you remember how many people can board a train. It's a lot. So for our family, we have decided not to upgrade the old combustion engine Nissan and just keep driving that until the wheels fall off. But until then, all our smaller rides that we can justify make a lot more sense to take the electric bike or a regular bike or walking or the city bus or all the other ways that are more efficient than driving, which is a lot.